Hey people, this is Talem Splash, and welcome back to my Let's Play of Final Fantasy XV. In the last part, we met up with Iris, finally, and we met Jared and Talget. Two of other really cool characters, in my opinion. So, we got a tip from Talket that there might be a royal arm in the cave behind the waterfall, so that's where we're gonna go next. But, first, I noticed I have so much AP, so I'm gonna actually spend some ascension points now while I have a chance to. So, Chain Fury, we'll go ahead and get that. Yes, okay. I know, I saw some questions about the wait mode, and that actually does have its own thing, like no mercy, boost damage inflicted by a scanned enemy's weakness. I don't really use wait mode, so I kind of leave this to last to level. It doesn't take that long to level, honestly. Like, you could, if you focus it, you could get it done really early on if you're like a wait mode user. I don't really use it, so I'm not too worried. I'll fill it out eventually, but for now, I just want to get the big stuff going. So recovery and combat and all that stuff. Man, see those trains going by, just like usual, just like the old days. Savior's Fortitude, boost an ally's defense after taking them out of danger. That's a nice one to have, I'd say. And increase HP recovery rate while hanging after point warp. That's also good. I want that as well. And rapid regen, raise both MP and HP recovery rate while in cover. All right, that's also good. All these good skills. First aid, yeah. All right, well, that's, you know, why not? I'm trying to get all the cheap ones so we get a lot of things. Even though the expensive ones are nice, it's not. I don't think it's a huge deal because ooh, boost stamina. That's good. I want that one. I'd rather have a lot of small things that are also still good before we start getting the more pricey ones. Boost warp strike damage is good. Boost blindside damage. Warp decoy. That's nice because the enemies will, I think, attack the decoy for a slight amount of time. Which is good because then significantly increased damage dealt after entering stasis. Yeah, that's good too. We're gonna leave it like that. See, it's just these tiny things just change the way the game is played entirely. I'll leave the 42 AP. I want to build some up. So let's get ourselves in that car and drive over to quest location, the sword in the waterfall. Let's get going.
Everything in order.
Yes, everything's in order. It's kind of late, 16 o'clock, but I think we'll be okay. Maybe we'll make it in time. I don't know. Let's put some music on. Speaking of Fisherman's Horizon from the last video, we're gonna play that because I like Fisherman's Horizon. It's a good song. It's probably one of the best tracks in Final Fantasy VIII, and Final Fantasy VIII is one of the best soundtracks in the series. I'm probably gonna be playing a lot of that, at least until I get 12. I didn't check the shops to see if they had music in Lestalem. Oh well, I'll be back. You always come back to Lestalem. It's a pretty common town that you return to at least 3 or 4 times in the open world part of the story, so yeah, it's kind of like your hub city for a while, and it's nice. I really like Lestalem for that. It's a very good Rabanaster, if you know what I mean, because Rabanaster was the hub. Man, it's pretty, that's for sure. So what are you guys up to today? I can't really say that I'm putting this up the day after I put up the last one. I probably am, but I can't really promise that because it really depends on my schedule and what I have going on. I have to have time to not only to record this, but also to edit it and stuff, and it takes so much time. But what have I been doing lately? The Nier demo. I uploaded the Nier demo recently, and that was so much fun to record. Oh, I'm gonna get that game day one. Unfortunately, I can't LP it day one because I gotta focus on Kingdom Hearts. Priorities, I know. But after that, I'm gonna get back to Nier because Nier was such a fun experience, and the art direction is by Akihiko Yoshida, which is like, oh my gosh! He did the art for 14, 12, Tactics, Bravely Default, Final Fantasy III's Remake. So many good things he did the art direction for. Okay, there's a Koenix bypass, another parking spot. He didn't do any drawing for this game, because this is all Nomura's art. There was like another dude that's not usually like part of the dev team that did a lot of the character art for the side characters and stuff in this game too. And they did a pretty good job, I would say, because I like the way all the side characters look. Their designs are pretty spot on for the most part. Like, you know, you have characters like Loki and we already saw, and then like of course the side ones like Iris and Talket and Jared and stuff like that. But Nomura did like the main characters, like these four. Our good old four, team of four, Nomura did. And then he left to go work on Kingdom Hearts 3. And that's fine, honestly. I didn't fill up on gas. Oops. I'm okay on gas, though, so I'm not too worried. But yeah, I'm pretty happy with the game in Tabata's hands. I still have to get my review up. I haven't done that either. It's been so busy. I promise I'll get it up at some point. I have to, because I'm already halfway done with it. I'm more than halfway done with it. I've gotten like a good portion. I just have to finish it up. And then once I finish it up again, though, I'll throw it up on YouTube. And, you know, just then I'll have my review out. So there's our destination over there. Man, this is so pretty. Oh, like, I love driving. This driving is so cool. And I like how they stick to the right side of the lane, you know, because usually in Japanese games, they tend to do it the opposite, because I wonder if in the Japanese release, did they flip it? Did they mirror the steering wheel? Or, like, at least mirror the car? I wouldn't be surprised. No, because Noctis always sits on the left. So, I don't know. I'm not really sure how they did that. But here we are at our parking spot. This is, the Burbost Souvenir Emporium. The Burbost. I don't know how you pronounce it. We can fill up on gas here, though, so I'm probably going to go and do that. Now that we're at the spot we need to be. Yeah. Get out of the car, guys. You don't need the car. Get back to the car, Noct. Let's refuel. Yeah. There you go. Yeah, you know, it's funny. I've never actually filled up a car with gasoline myself. Because even though I have my driver's license, I never drive. Because I live in Chicago, so I usually take public transportation. And, like, of course, in the suburbs, I drive from time to time. But it's not my car, so I've never been the one to fill up the gas. And I'm pretty sure it's really easy. It's kind of like, you know, it's like the first time you, like when you're a kid, the first time you learn to do laundry, it seems magical. And then you just do it one day when you're like 12. Like, I started doing my laundry when I was like 12. And then it's like the easiest thing in the world. But yeah, I don't know. We're good on chocobos. I'm checking for items. I want these items. Oh, two things here. We got Deadly Water Sahagin. Okay. A Pyrefly Motor Oil. Lube that lasts through the roughest rides. Well, okay. I'm sure Noctis will need that. That's for sure. Spider Silk. Okay. I don't know what Spider Silk is used for. I guess for, like, materials and stuff. Wildlife Alert and Catalan Plunge. Attack and the Angler's Increasing. Okay. I gotta do more fishing, too. More fishing. What's on the radio today? Oh, not Kenny. No, screw on, Kenny. Cheese chips. Okay, there's no one in here. Before.
And give it a try.
I mean, the shop isn't open. I can't buy anything. Belly, huh?
No doubt about it.
No doubt about it. It's fine. We're just going to move ahead on here on ourselves, on our lonesome. Let's get on our chocobos. How do I do that again? I forgot. You call the chocobo like this. Yeah, hi, chocobo. Hello, my friend. I'm not going to color Let's you. Go. I want to keep you yellow. I colored it green in my solo playthrough. Or not my solo playthrough, but my Let's Play playthrough. And, oh yeah, we have to, what is it, trot with L2? Yeah, there we go. I was like, how do I move this chocobo? It's not like 14, that's for sure. Okay, we don't get off here. We keep going. No, we get off here. Okay, yeah, we do get off here. We, go down these stairs. I forgot how they changed the jump button, too. There we go. Thank goodness you can't take fall damage on a chocobo. Alrighty. Oh, this is pretty. I hope I'm going the right way. I mean, I remember going down here before.
Man, that hurts.
What hurts?
Another headache.
Oh, this yeah.
Not normal.
I could grab that, but I don't care. Oh, alright, we have to watch out. There's actually a Midgard Zormer here. I don't want to fight it. It's pretty prickly. I think it's like level 50 or something. I tried fighting it my first time, and I was like, huh, no. That's not happening. We could fight these things. Yeah, alright, let's get out and let's kill these things. We can totally handle these. They're only level 18, and we haven't done any fighting yet. Oh, yes. There we go, it feels good to fight again. Oh, I didn't block in time. Oh, I think they're weak to spears, maybe? Oh, I still have wait mode on, too, I just realized that. I gotta turn that off. Block that, parry that. Boom, block that. And attack, alrighty. Let's go ahead. Oh, I can't do a Gravisphere yet. Okay. Yeah, we don't want to get near that Midgard Zormer at all, though. If we can help it, that Midgard Zormer will shred us to bits, and it barely gives us any experience either. Alright, now let's do a Gravisphere. Go ahead, Prompto. Do your Gravisphere thing. Oh, man, I love Gravisphere so much. It's like with Aqua using Magnet, except, like, even cooler because it lasts for a long time.
I'm counting on it.
Yeah. And it just looks so cool. I got 3 fire energy.
What's what?
I've come up with a new recipe.
Oh, great.
I could taste test for you.
Ooh, a creamy crustacean omelet. That sounds pretty delicious. You know, I should have maybe tomorrow before work I'll go and have some eggs, because I've been having waffles every day since I bought like a ton of waffles. And I was like, oh man, I need waffles now, and I'm not going the right way, am I? I might be. I don't know. Maybe I can go this way. There's a Mega Phoenix. That's good. I can't. Oh, come on. I thought I was going the right way. Is this just lead? No, it is the right way. I can go. No, I can't go in the water. No. All right. Ugh. Man, I thought I was. That looks all right. Maybe on my chocobo. Let's get on my chocobo. Where you at, Choco? Oh my gosh, Chocobo, where you at? You're not here. Do I have to go on the other side? You're probably on the other side of the rocks, aren't you? No. My Chocobo, where are you? Let me call you again. There you are. Okay, I need your help.
Easy
it's getting
now.
Late, and I need your spotlight. Let's okay, let's go up here. What is that? That's a sign. Okay. Catalan's Plunge. Okay. I think I'm going the right way. I don't know. No, yeah, this is the right way. Your bird refuses to go any further. Okay, yeah, this has to be the right way. If the bird is refusing to go further, all right, get off. Get off the bird, Noctis. Just Noctis, get off the bird. Thank you. It's like I was holding down
nice
that button.
Nice riding with you.
Roll me again.
Says, look behind the waterfall.
Yeah, here we
what
are.
What does the waterfall say?
I think it says come in.
Prompto, you're stupid. Prompto, please. Prompto, please. All right. Well, it's interesting that we're doing this at night. When I did this the first time, it was not nighttime, that's for sure. The Glacier Glacial Grotto. Oh, it's a dungeon. Oh, I remember this one. So what you want to do is you actually want to put on the warm gear, because it'll actually make a difference. Oh, yeah, I got my royal raiments. Casual outfit with the jacket. Oh, that's the casual outfit without the jacket. There's the jacket. Let's get all these people warm. There you go. Unfortunately, I guess for Ignis, it doesn't really matter. We'll just go with the regular one because he's warm. Yeah, for Prompto, he doesn't, all of his things are sleeveless, so he just gets to be cold.
Double back for our coats?
You don't have a coat.
Little chill won't kill you.
Yeah.
Well, looking on the bright side, maybe the cold keeps the demons at bay?
Yeah, because monsters like warm.
Oh, I gotta turn off. Let's turn off whip mode really quick. Options. Where is it? Combat. Active. There we go. I like how it has the FF12 lines, though. That's pretty cool. Boom. Oh, man. That damage is pretty, pretty. That's for sure. Oh, wait. Am I? Oh, this. Like, I'm not dealing that. It says it's, like, not very effective, but I'm still, like, close to one-shotting them, which I think is really funny because we have the Ultima Blade. Oh man, they're dealing a couple damages on me though. Noctis, that's the wall.
Watch yourself, Noct.
I know.
That's the wall. Okay, that's dead.
Here goes nothing.
None the worse for wear.
What? Here goes what, Prompto? You didn't do anything. Oh, it's a slide. It's a slide. Oh, I missed the thingy. I was supposed to turn, wasn't I? That's fine. Oh, we got imps now. And these imps are actually, like, really similar to the Final Fantasy 1 design, which I think is so cool. Yeah. They're nice and easy to defeat. Nice and quick. I gotta be sure I, hold down that button instead of mash it, though. You're dead. There we go. Yeah, I know that the low-level game came out now. I was thinking of trying that out at some point, but, I don't know. Low-level games I usually do after I know the game very well, and I still don't know 15 that well yet. I will at some point, probably. I probably won't record it. I might record, like, boss fights or something, or maybe I'll stream it. I don't know.
So much.
Don't really think about it. I just sort of do what I want on this channel, that's for sure. I'll talk about what I want. Like, for instance, right now, we're going to talk about... What should we talk about?
Really?
Yes, sliding again. Let's talk about Majora's Mask. This reminds me of, like, the Snowfall Temple. Or, not Snowfall Temple, what is it? Why am I forgetting? It is... No, it's not Snowfall.
Snowhead, yeah. Snowhead and Woodfall.
Yeah, there you go. I fell on the ice again. Okay, here's where we wanted to go. This is the Arachne. Yeah, it's Snowhead Temple. Thank you, Cody. it kind of reminds me of that, because it's got that sort of... it has that same aesthetic of not only like being icy, but also like a lot of... ground stuff as well, because Snowhead was always really rocky, like you had to move like those bricks in the middle and all that. Whereas like the ice cavern in Ocarina of Time was like all ice and you had like no stone or anything. This is like a cave and it's pretty. This is, like, I think the only ice area in the game, too. We can go down here.
Yeah.
Alright, just, come on, lock on to the enemies. There we go. I'm wasting MP trying to, like, warp strike around, and I'm not getting anything. Oh, this is so easy with the Ultima Blade. So easy. Let's get this. What is this? The fossil shell. Yeah, I want to get back to playing Majora's Mask because I was playing, or I lost my file when I lost my 3DS a while ago, and then I have it again because I got a new 3DS for Majora's Mask 3D, but I never bothered to replay through the game because like I had so much progress, like that was 100% file. I just couldn't bring myself to do it again that early, but I will at some point because playing that I play through that game every once in a while. I never finished my LP of it, that's for sure, though. You know, me and Cody had, like, a good 10 videos that we never uploaded. And they're gone now, unfortunately. But one day we'll go back to it and maybe redo it again, because Majora's Mask is a fun game to do. All right, we have to go north. So let's go this way. I know we have a boss at some point. See, it just keeps on dead-ending. Like, we keep getting a dead end, and that's what I didn't like about this dungeon, is, like, no matter where you go, you're kind of not going the right way until you go all the way around or something. Let's try this way. All right, we can go this way. And then we'll try going around this way. And ooh, yeah, there's treasure here, which means I probably haven't gone this way yet. This is a high potion. High potions are good. Yeah. High potions are pretty OP in this game, too. Like, in other games are not... Okay, don't fall back down there. In other games, they're okay, but, like, they're not that great in the long... Just in the grand scheme of things, like, they'll be good for a while. And then, like, in 12, Larsa throwing the unlimited high potions was great for a long time until, you know, Larsa left, and then high potions were suddenly so obsolete that they didn't even matter. That was in Vanilla 12, not in the international version. So, for the Zodiac Age, you won't be able to Larsa trick... Well, it's not really a trick. You won't be able to abuse Larsa with his potions, though. That's for sure. Which will be fun, because he gets Bubble instead, which is great. Bubble is such a good spell. Bubble multiplies your max HP by 2, and he's the first one that can cast that early on in the game. And it's so useful, because you can get so many hunts done with Larsa, just because you have twice the amount of max HP you have. You can just get so much done. Oh, man, that camera shot is not what I like to see. 15... Come on, 15. Come on, 15. We're getting a decent amount of experience. I don't want to use my, I should probably craft a spell. I don't want to use anything until I, or my experience casts, until we get to the boss, though. That's for sure. I want to get Phyra. Maybe? No, it's going to turn it into Thundara if I use too many. Actually, yeah, let's just keep it with fire, and then... Oh, I mean, this will increase the potency, though. Let's increase the potency to 99. 99 potency, so that way we deal... Okay. Before it becomes a thunder. Come on, go back. Okay, there we go. And now we can go to our D-base coin and craft ourselves some nice Experiencast Fire. EXP bonus level 4. And we'll equip that. We'll put that on Calamity. Because I want to be ready for that boss fight. I don't want to have to go into the menu as soon as the boss spawns. And since we're in the dungeon, I'm going to go a little bit longer on this one. Probably because also this is the last one I'll be able to record tonight. Which means I won't be having a video every day this week, unfortunately. Because I won't have time tomorrow because class. And then after the day after, I have raid. And it's just, so many things.
Your tips just got frosted, dude.
Really? How's it look?
I don't see any frosted tips on Noctis. I think you lied, Prompto. I think you weren't being entirely truthful. I fell down. Oh, please tell me I was supposed to do that. Please tell. Okay, this doesn't look familiar, so I think I'm okay. No, I was here. Oh my gosh, I am so dumb. I might just meet you back where I was, because that's gonna be quite the run. It's just I didn't even mean to fall. Like I wasn't telling Noctis to. We just sort of like decided, hey, this looks like a good direction to go down. I'll slide here, see what happens, and then he slides back down to where I was. And I'm already a third of a mile away from where I need to be. 0.3 miles. It's midnight right now. Midnight in-game, and 10:36 in real life. Oh god, I didn't press the thing. There we go. At least, maybe that's a good thing. I don't want Noctis running back down again. I need to slide back under that thing again. Is Prompto going to say my tips got frosted? No, he's not. Okay. Alright, let's go this way this time. Not go down that slide, but get close to the edge so we can pick this up. A carbon bangle. And what's that down there? Okay, that's just light. Don't fall. Just cross. That's all you have to do is cross the bridge. Oh, what's here, though? Don't fall. Don't... Okay. There's nothing here. This is just a... Oh, it's just a troll. Excuse me, Gladio. You're in my way. I don't care if Prompto's down there. Okay, that's where I came from? No, that's a new direction, isn't it? I think. Yeah, this is new. Okay, yeah. Okay, cool. We're going the right way. Just continue until we get a royal arm. There's some fossil wood. You know... Could I borrow some wood for a moment, please? When McGonagall says that, okay, when in Harry Potter 1, when I was reading it for the first time, and Oliver Wood comes into the story, when I was little, I must have been like 9 or 10 when I was reading the first book, I thought that Oliver Wood was an actual plank of wood. Like Harry thought in the beginning too, but I thought like even after he was introduced as a character that like the entire time he was just wood, and that was it. Oh boy, okay. I didn't realize we're fighting a samurai. Oh, yes. Yeah, block that, please. Oh my gosh! You did that. That dealt quite a number on me. Let's go ahead and use a potion on me. Yes, use a potion. Get out of there. Not this. Alright. Man, not. Oh my god, this camera is so bad at times. Let's just use an elixir. Screw it. Because we're already at half max HP anyway. I don't want to have to bother with, like. Yeah, alright. Yeah, the Ronins are kind of tricky here. Just gotta be sure you block them. Alright, I'm blocking this one right now. And parry. Prompto, no! Alright. Let's go ahead and use, he's dead. I have to use a Phoenix down on him. Actually, I wonder, does he come back after the fight? Because in that case, I'm not gonna use it. Yeah, he comes back. Okay, yeah, I'm not gonna waste a Phoenix down if he'll just come back. I've never actually tried that. Let's just continue, now that we've killed our Ronin. And Prompto, you need an elixir as well, so... Here you go, you have one. You earned it, buddy. Use it, Prompto! Use the elixir! Okay. Thank you! It takes so long sometimes, these characters. Like, they're not really sure what to do. They're just like, oh, you want me to use it? Are you sure? Well, let me think about that for a minute. And then they don't use it. And, you know, sometimes you'll enter in the command and they just won't use it, period. I came from this way, so I have to go back this way. Man, this dungeon is so complicated to get around. Don't tell me this is going back to the start. It better not be. Please don't go back to the start. Yeah, let's play some tunes. It keeps reminding me. We'll do... Alright, yeah, we'll do Waltz for the Moon, because that's sort of a chaotic track. Okay, this goes back here. Alright, yeah, it's Cody closing the door. I think he's taking a shower or something. Because it's getting kind of late. I have to work on homework after this, too. So, wait, don't fall. What is this? An ammonite fossil, okay. Man, alright. So, we could go this way. We'll go down, and then we'll take that side path this time. And we should be good. Just... Yes, alright. Push sideways. Oh my god, Noctis! Oh, the camera! Oh my gosh! Oh, can I save in here? I can't save in dungeons. Because he's crouching. I learned that. Like, you can't save when you're crouching for some reason. So I can't save my game until I'm done with this dungeon. And I can't get out of this dungeon until I actually do the puzzle right. So we might be here for quite a while until I figure this out. Okay, ooh! Oh, this is new. Alright. Stick to the wall. Maybe this is the way you need to go. Unless this is just where we came from before. No, this is just where we were before. We're gonna go down back here, and it's gonna take us down here, and this is where the dead end was. So I'm at a loss of where to go, unless it's this way. It is this way. Okay. Cody's giving me the thumbs up. What's up, Cody?
I was just saying that.
Watch your step.
I did the right thing. Yeah, I guess I did. I wish I could take off Noctis's hat. It's kind of dumb, don't you think?
Great.
Yeah, I mean, I like it.
I wish there were more cosmetic options in general.
Yeah, there's only the main three, and then all the rest are kind of DLC. Ooh, there's a fire thingy. Oh man, if I had waited to get this fire, I could have just used it all One. I could have just thought my spear cast could have been like a Fyra instead.
This seems... I did not see that coming.
Okay. This is... Oh, this is just... Oh, this is, I don't know if this is the boss, but we're gonna use a fire anyway, just in case.
Die on me.
Okay, there we go. Just get... Block it, block it. Noctis, I said block it. Oh boy. Block that one, please. Thank you. There we go, it's dead. That was actually pretty fast. Okay, maybe I shouldn't have used the Xperia cast on that. I thought I trigger-fingered into thinking that was the boss, but I suppose it wasn't. Oh no, actually, I remember the boss in this dungeon, and it's different up. Because...
Did you double-check?
Triple-checked.
Triple-checked what?
Then we're done.
Where to next?
Yeah. Let's just head on this way, maybe? Maybe? Yeah, okay. No, I'm going in a circle. I'm going in a circle again. Okay, don't fall off, because I feel like that's... No, okay, this actually might be the right way to go. No. That it looks like the bad way to go, because I see there's a wall there. Let's just go back here. I don't know, this dungeon's super confusing. I'm sorry this video is going on so long. I might actually just split this up into two parts and not have an intro for one of them or something.
Don't know where we came from, don't know where we're going.
Let's see. Let's look at our map again. So we should be going... Okay, well, what if we dip down this way? And yeah, this is it. Okay, because yeah, we haven't been here yet. Yeah, Cody's using the sink. I'm sorry if you hear that. It's probably going to pick up, but it's okay. It's not a huge deal at the moment because it's just combat. If it was a cutscene, I would kill him. Oh man, look at that one shot though. I was going to kill you if you used the sink during the cutscene. Yes, I do. So I guess yeah, you're right. I have no backup for that. you're fundamentally right. I mute the audio during every cutscene usually. All right, let's just. Yeah, but no, you're not doing that. Well, let's point one over there. Heal up a little bit. Yeah. Now you're gonna make the one person who hasn't actually figured out that spoiler yet be all sad.
Put it in the books.
Although I'm sure anyone who doesn't know who Aerith, or anyone who doesn't know that Aerith dies, doesn't know who Aerith is.
Do you not know who Luke Skywalker's dad is?
And we could tell you that.
What's the item you have on the left?
That is a royal arm.
Oh,
that's the axe, which is really good for warp striking. Okay, I figured out the way to go. You go this way.
Not a fan.
Yes.
Mushy desserts.
Mushy desserts. The flan.
Forget about us. You can tell us what to do.
Okay, I can't tell you what to do. You don't have any, I don't have any things to order you. I don't have any ordering points. Alright, there we go. Lightning energy from that is good, I suppose. Just kill this thing. I want to get to the boss. Yeah, alright, I'm definitely going to make this two videos, I think. I haven't done that since the Zelda days, since I was doing Majora's Mask, speaking of that. But I figured like that's the best thing to do in this situation because this otherwise it's going to be like a 40-minute long video. Getting through this dungeon, I didn't expect to be that long. Okay, this is the way you want to go. Just this way. So, oh yeah, Balam Garden playing now? Alright, I guess that's fine.
Let's see for ourselves.
Alright, well we're capped up on thunder. And yeah, see, I get to the thing and then the exclamation part just moves on me. It's like, huh, you thought that was the end. But in fact, you're only halfway there. Okay, let's, oh, we have another Ronin. Crap. I'm blocking. There we go, see? Look at that block. That block that one-shots you. That's so perfect. I'm blocking again. I'm parrying. Oh, man, that's so good. With the Ultima Blade, these Ronins are a joke. There we go. And you're dead. I think you're dead. No, you're not dead yet. Okay, yeah, you are dead. Good. I got kind of scared for a second because he wasn't dying. And I was like, uh-oh. He's going to land another attack, and I don't know if I can take another attack from him. Oh, kill the flan, Noctis. Don't fall. If you fall, Noctis, oh my gosh, did you see that? That was pretty scary.
Better than good.
Good to go.
I feel like this is where we were. No, it's not where we were. We're in a new spot. Okay, just get back on there again. Proceed once more. Proceed through the ice. And when we're moving, I gotta use another elixir on Noctis soon.
Oh, what I wouldn't give for a hot bowl of soup. Soup.
You know, almost playing there. the Balum yeah, garden theme, and I'm sorry, the open world map theme in from 8 makes me like remember the Ifrit part in the beginning. It's kind of like the opposite because we're going into an ice cavern instead of a fire cavern. Let's change the music. We'll do the oath right on the castle. Actually, let's go to. Do I have 14 yet? No, I don't. Okay. Well, we have Matoya's cave. Alright, I don't think I've heard this arrangement of Matoya's cave, but since we're in a cave, I guess it's kind of fitting.
Hey, not now. Can it ever be easy?
Alright, so this is the boss for sure. This is the mind flare. Okay, yeah, you know because the boss music is playing for once. I don't know why I didn't think of that. Prompto, no! Here, use an elixir. You need it. You need it, buddy. Let's do that. And, cool. We will. Let's get away from you. Alright, here we go. I should probably use an elixir myself as well. Here we go. And just wait to get the next Xperia cast. I want to double Xperia cast on this thing, because. Yeah. There we go, now we'll get extra experience, and we're probably going to kill it too. And the fire is doing great to deal some nice damage to it. There we go. We good? We good? Now we got more imps. Is that- oh my god, that Mindflayer's still alive? Did it just revive itself? Because I swear it was fine, and then suddenly it's like back to alright, Ignis, do your mark. Let's get some weaknesses on these things. And then after that, we'll do a Gravisphere. Okay. Boom! Man, Prompto's Gravisphere is so good. In, like, any situation. Look at all these... look at these raining damage in numbers. Just raining damage. There we go. That one's dead. Are there two? Did it split? It split! Well, we can just kill this one too, then. See, look at that. Screw you.
Does this mean we can go back outside?
In a minute. We gotta get this royal arm first. It only took us 32 minutes of this video. Man, it's not. It's almost like that's almost not long enough to justify two, but it is still long enough. Now that we're finally here, I liked that though. That was a fun. That was a fun little dungeon. I like the dungeon. The dungeons in this game in general. They're pretty. Pretty fun to explore. I got lost. I got a little bit frustrated getting lost, but you know that you just gotta take that. Let's pick this up. And there we go. We got, now we can conjure the Armiger. Okay, so Noctis can conjure the Armiger. His arsenal of royal arms and the circular Armiger bar is full. So that's basically, it's an ascension thing too. It's basically, it's Noctis' limit break. For all intents and purposes, the Armiger is his limit break. It's really nice. And, oh man, we got a ton of experience. Let's return to the entrance. And as soon as I can save, I am. Because it's been 3 videos now and I haven't saved once. In any of them, and I know I have the audio save, but the auto save rather. Not another headache.
Noct, you okay?
What did I? Where was that?
What is it?
A hole in the ground. Something burning. The meteor?
You saw the disc of Kothis. Let's make our way back to Lestalem.
Yeah, gotta report to Talcott.
Yep, because we finally did Talcott's bidding. But for now, we're gonna save our game because it's been a while. And then in the next part, I'm not going to play anymore since before that part, so don't worry. I'm not going to do anything off-screen this time. I know I did the I got the Ultima Blade off-screen, but you know what? That's fine. I'm not going to do anything else off-screen. We're just going to keep pressing on here. Don't look at that save file. Don't want to spoil you guys. We will save on this one, Chapter 2 Legacy. I'm sort of just saving on, like, these are my three failsafe saves, so that one will be the way that we're doing for now. So, the way of gods and kings. I'll see you in the next part. Thank you so much for watching. I'm sorry that this video didn't have an intro, and I'm sorry that the last video didn't have an outro, but you know what? You gotta take what you can when you're making these longer videos like this. Oh, it's kind of fun, though. I must admit, it brings me back to the old days. So, I'll see you in the next video, which I don't know what part it'll be, but I'm sure it'll be a fun one, that's for sure. All right. Bye, everybody. Take care. Sleep well and eat your food and do your homework and all that stuff. Later.